So the Prophet ﷺ is being told, the mushrikun, they will find your message very difficult. The people of the book, they have a doubt. So you would think, the Prophet ﷺ would probably think like, so I might as well stop giving da'wah then. What's the point of continuing with da'wah? And then the Prophet ﷺ is being told, yes, this is the situation, but you still have to give da'wah. فَلِذَٰلِكَ فَدْعُوا
الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ مَالِكِ يَوْمِ الدِّينِ إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. شرع لكم من الدين ما وصى به نوحا والذي أوحينا إليك وما وصينا به إبراهيم وموسى وعيسى أن أقيموا الدين ولا تتفرقوا فيه كبر على المشركين ما تدعوهم إليه الله يجتبي إليه من يشاء ويهدي إليه من ينيب وما تفرقوا إلا من بعد ما جاءهم العلم بغيا بينهم ولولا كلمة سبقت من ربك إلى أجل مسمى لقضي بينهم وإن الذين أورثوا الكتاب من بعدهم لفي شك منه مريب فلذلك فادع واستقم كما أمرت ولا تتبع أهواءهم وقل آمنت بما أنزل الله من كتاب وأمرت لأعدل بينكم الله ربنا وربكم لنا أعمالنا ولكم أعمالكم لا حجة بيننا وبينكم الله يجمع بيننا وإليه المصير والذين يحاجون في الله من بعد ما استجيب له حجتهم داحضة عند ربهم وعليهم غضب ولهم عذاب شديد الله الذي أنزل الكتاب بالحق والميزان وما يدريك لعل الساعة قريب يستعجل بها الذين لا يؤمنون بها والذين آمنوا مشفقون منها ويعلمون أنها الحق ألا إن الذين يمارون في الساعة لفي ضلال بعيد الله لطيف بعباده يرزق من يشاء وهو القوي العزيز من كان يريد حرث الآخرة نزد له في حرثه ومن كان يريد حرث الدنيا نؤته منها وما له في الآخرة من نصيب أم لهم شركاء شرعوا لهم من الدين ما لم يأذن به الله ولولا كلمة الفصل لقضي بينهم وإن الظالمين لهم عذاب أليم ترى الظالمين مشفقين مما كسبوا وهو واقع بهم والذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات في روضات الجنات لهم ما يشاءون عند ربهم ذلك هو الفضل الكبير.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear brothers, الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله. Inshallah ta'ala, before we begin the journey this morning, I want to tell you a journey that I have undertaken yesterday myself physically. This was a physical journey. Yesterday I went to Leicester. I have been to our Sheikh's grandson's wedding, Sheikh Abdullah. And mashallah, as you know, that the Sheikh's youngest son got married on Tuesday. And some of us, alhamdulillah, went to see him in London. And yesterday, alhamdulillah, his eldest grandson was getting married in Leicester. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them, Allahumma ameen. And as you can see, mashallah, within the last few days, the Sheikh, the family of the Sheikh, alhamdulillah, they had two weddings. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make these two weddings successful ones. Allahumma ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the Sheikh and his family. Allahumma ameen. And the Sheikh was sending his special salam to all of you, and he was very grateful and thankful to all of you. And I told him, mashallah, the salam and the well wishes of the whole community, and that they have sent you an amazing well wishes and also so much dua. And the Sheikh was so grateful for that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from all of us. Allahumma ameen. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, and inshallah ta'ala, we'll begin with our journey today with the ayah, shara'a lakum min ad-din ma wassa bihi nuhan walladhi awhayna ilayk. Do you know, sometimes as Muslims, and those people who are not Muslims, they accuse the Muslims of copying Christianity, for example, or Judaism. And they say, you're copying the previous religions. We are not copying the previous religions, because the previous religions and the religion that the Prophet ﷺ came with is just one religion. Inna ad-deena 'inda Allahi al-Islam. The religion in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one religion, and that religion is Islam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, شَرَعَ لَكُم مِّنَ الدِّينِ مَا وَصَّى بِهِ نُوحًا وَالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ وَمَا وَصَّيْنَا بِهِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى وَعِيسَى أَنْ أَقِيمُوا الدِّينَ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ كَبُرَ عَلَى الْمُشْرِكِينَ مَا تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَيْهِ اللَّهُ يَجْتَبِي إِلَيْهِ مَن يَشَاءُ وَيَهْدِي إِلَيْهِ مَن يُنِيبُ. الله أكبر. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, شَرَعَ لَكُم مِّنَ الدِّينِ مَا وَصَّى بِهِ نُوحًا. Allah has ordained for you the same religion. Allah has ordained for you the same religion which He ordained for Prophet Nuh alayhi salam. So our religion is the same religion that was given to Prophet Nuh alayhi salam, which is the religion of Islam. And not only that, and that which we have inspired in you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that which we ordained for Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, and Prophet Musa, and Prophet Isa, saying you should establish religion, and aqimu ad-deen wa la tatafarraqu fih, and make no divisions in it, meaning in religion. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, intolerable for the mushrikun. Kabura, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, when He has mentioned, كَبُرَ عَلَى الْمُشْرِكِينَ مَا تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَيِّهِ, what was so hard for the mushrikun, for the idol worshippers? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, what you are calling them to, which is tawheed. The mushrikun, they hate tawheed. Tawheed, what is it? The oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كَبُرَ عَلَى الْمُشْرِكِينَ مَا تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَيْهِ اللَّهُ يَجْتَبِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He chooses for Himself whom He wills. and guides unto himself who turns to him in repentance and in ordain, in also in obedience. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us in this ayah, the religion that was given to all these amazing prophets, beginning with Prophet Nuh alayhi salam, and also then after that Prophet Ibrahim, and then Prophet Musa alayhi salam, and Prophet Isa, all of them, and the one that was given to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, all of them are from the same religion. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the one who has given it to them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, what you are calling to, which is tawheed, is so hard for the mushrikun. Just imagine imagine the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he's being educated every single day. And he's being told, yes, we have given you a mission, but the mission we have given you is not going to be an easy mission. These people that you are inviting them to Islam, they hate Islam. Tawheed is very difficult for them. كَبُّرَ عَلَى الْمُشْرِكِينَ مَا تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَيْهِ اللَّهُ يَجْتَبِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ شَاءَ. And then the Prophet is being told, Allah chooses whomever he wants. وَيَهْدِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ يُنِيبُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides those who come back to him, those who repent back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides. And then the Prophet also is being told, وَمَا تَفَرَّقُوا إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَهُمُ الْعِلْمُ بَغْيًا بَيْنَهُمْ. And they divided not till after knowledge had come to them. The ulama, they said, who does Allah mean here? Does he mean the mushrikun? Or does he mean the people of the book? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and they divided not till after knowledge had come to them. Some of the ulama, they said, this means the mushrikun of Quraysh, they have only divided after knowledge came to them. Meaning some of them believed in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, others disbelieved. Because they used to say, وَأَقْسَمُوا بِاللَّهِ جَهْدَ أَيْمَانِهِمْ لَإِنْ جَاءَهُمْ نَذِيرٌ لَيَكُونُنَّ أَهْدَى مِنْ إِحْدَى الْأُمَمِ. They used to say, if a prophet, if a warner was to be sent to us, we would be the most guided of people. But when the Prophet ﷺ was sent to them, that wasn't the case. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا تَفَرَّقُوا إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَهُمُ الْعِلْمُ بَغْيًا بَيْنَهُمْ. And then Allah said, وَلَوْلَا كَلِمَةٌ سَبَقَتْ مِنْ رَبِّكَ إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ مُسَمَّنْ لَقُضِيَ بَيْنَهُمْ. If it had not been for a decree already passed by your Lord to reprieve them until an appointed time, they would already have been judged. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, had I not decreed that these people, I'm going to give them time and I'm not going to punish them immediately after they reject my message, I would have actually punished them by now. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَإِنَّ الَّذِينَ أُورِثُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ لَفِي شَكٍ مِنْهُمْ مُرِيبٌ. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَإِنَّ الَّذِينَ أُورِثُوا الْكِتَابَ. Those after them who inherited the scripture are in disquieting doubt about it. So the people of the book, those who were given to Torah, those who were given to Injil, what has happened? وَإِنَّهُمْ لَفِي شَكٍّ وَإِنَّهُمْ لَفِي شَكٍّ وَإِنَّ الَّذِينَ أُورِثُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ لَفِي شَكٍّ مِنْهُمْ مُرِيبٌ. So even those ones, when the Prophet ﷺ was sent to them, they do have a doubt. They don't want to follow the Prophet ﷺ. So the Prophet ﷺ is being told, the mushrikun, they will find your message very difficult. The people of the book, they have a doubt. So you would think, the Prophet ﷺ would probably think like, so I might as well stop giving da'wah then. What's the point of continuing with da'wah? And then the Prophet has been told, yes, this is the situation, but you still have to give da'wah. فَلِذَٰلِكَ فَدْعُوا. Subhanallah. The Prophet is being told, yes, this is the situation, but still you can't say, what's the point of me giving da'wah? Stop the da'wah. Okay? The Prophet says, yes, your task is difficult, but you have to continue giving da'wah. As Muslims right now, sometimes you feel like, oh, what's the point of giving da'wah? No one is listening to you. People are just preoccupied with this life. Nobody really cares about the next life. Sometimes you feel like you kind of like get and reach a state of despair where you feel like, what's the point of giving da'wah? But the Prophet is being told, yes, I have just told you all of that. But at the same time, I want to say to you, فَلِذَٰلِكَ فَدْعُوا وَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتْ. The Prophet is being told, so Prophet, call people to that faith and follow the straight path as you have been commanded. فَادْعُوا وَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتْ وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ. And do not go by what they desire, but say, I believe in whatever scripture Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down. I am commanded to bring justice between you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our Lord and your Lord. To us our deeds and to you yours. لَنَا أَعْمَالُنَا وَلَكُمْ أَعْمَالُكُمْ. لا حجة بيننا وبينكم. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, so let there be no argument between us and you. Allah yajma'u baynana. Allah will gather us together, and to him we shall return. Subhanallah. Very powerful. And now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also reminds the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah الذي أنزل الكتاب بالحق والميزان. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is Allah who has sent down the book, the books, al-kitab, or the scripture, with truth, with purpose, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and the balance, wal-mizan. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ لَعَلَّ السَّاعَةَ قَرِيبٌ. How can you tell the last hour may well be near? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, those who disbelieve the next life, they want the next life to come very quickly. يَسْتَعْجِلُ بِهَا الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, those who do not believe in it, meaning the next life, seek to hasten it. They say, bring it on. Whenever the Prophet ﷺ reminds them about the next life, when the Quran is revealed, reminding them about the next life, what do they say? Bring on the next life. We want the next life to begin right now. Let's see the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah said, يَسْتَعْجِلُ بِهَا الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهَا. Those who do not believe in it, seek to hasten it. But the believers stand in awe of it. The people who believe in the next life, they're very fearful of the next life. We are scared of the next life. Subhanallah. We're very scared of the next life. But those who do not believe in it, what do they say? Bring it on. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, أَلَا إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُمَارُونَ فِي السَّاعَةِ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ بَعِيدٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, those who argue about the hour are far, far astray. And then the next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allahu latifun bi'ibadihi. Allahu latifun. Look at how beautiful this ayah is. Allahu latifun bi'ibadihi yarzuqu man yasha. Allah is very gracious and kind to his slaves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the one who provides for those who believe in him and those who do not believe in him. Subhanallah. Those who are going against Allah day and night, he's the one who provides everything for them. He's the one who gives them health. Good health. He's the one who gives them the oxygen. He's the one who gives them the wealth that they have. He's the one who gives them the kids that they have. He's the one who gives them everything that they have, despite what? Them disbelieving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even though they don't like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, Allahu latifun bi'ibadihi yarzuqu man yasha. Allah is most subtle towards his creation. He provides bountifully for whoever he will. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the powerful, the almighty. And look at the next ayah. مَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ حَرْثَ الْآخِرَةِ نَزِدْ لَهُ فِي حَرْثِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if anyone desires a harvest in the life to come, do you know right now, you are investing in your next life. You are investing in your next life. That's why you woke up. This is an investment. Do you know, waking up at this difficult time is an amazing investment. Why? Because you're going to harvest this in the next life. Allah said, مَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ حَرْثَ الْآخِرَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, whosoever desires with his deeds the reward of the hereafter. If anyone desires a harvest in the life to come, Allah said, we shall increase it for him. Do you know every act of worship you're doing right now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will multiply it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us every act of good, every action of good that we do will be multiplied by 10 times. That's the minimum. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will multiply it up to 700 times. Wallahu yudha'ifu liman yasha. And some people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will multiply it for them without any limit. Subhanallah. Just imagine Allah said, man kana yuridu hartha al-akhirah, nazid lahu fi harthi. What about man kana yuridu hartha al-dunya? If anyone desires a harvest in this world, we shall give him a share of it. You know, those people who are striving for this life, Allah said, he's not going to give it to them all of it. He will give to them some of it, part of it. ومن كان يريد حرث الدنيا نؤته منها. And what else will happen to them? وما له في الآخرة من نصيب. But in the hereafter, he will have no share. Yes, the people who are for this dunya, the people who think about the life of this dunya and nothing else, Allah said, I will give to them part of this life. Not all of it, a portion of this life. But in the next life, they will have nothing. Subhanallah. But as Muslims, as believers, alhamdulillah, our investment is for the next life. You woke up right now. You came to the masjid. You prayed Salatul Fajr. And these are the best days of the year. mashallah, the first 10 days of the Hijjah. Just imagine, every second you are sitting right now, angels are writing down. And how much ajr are you going to get for this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, these days, our actions are very beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. So right now, as you are sitting down, as you are benefiting from Fajr reflection, as you have just prayed Salatul Fajr, okay, and every moment that you are here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's going to reward you. And this is an investment for the next life. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks this question, أَمْ لَهُمْ شُرَكَاءَ. How can they believe in others who ordained for them things which Allah has not sanctioned? أَمْ لَهُمْ شُرَكَاءُ شَرَعُوا لَهُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ. How can they believe in others who ordained for them things which Allah has not sanctioned in the practice of their faith? If it were not for Allah's decree concerning the final decision, judgment would already have been made between them. The evildoers will have grievous punishment. تَرَى الظَّالِمِينَ مُشْفِقِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, in the next life, what are we going to see? You will see them fearful because of what they have done. The kuffar, who are arrogant today, in the next life, they will be very fearful. تَرَى الظَّالِمِينَ مُشْفِقِينَ. You will see them fearful because of what they have done. Punishment is bound to fall on them. But those who believe and do good deeds will be in the flowering meadows of the garden. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those ones. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, they will have whatever they wish from their Lord. This is the great bounty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَضْلُ الْكَبِيرُ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us those who enjoy that amazing, amazing bounty in the next life. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us those who take heed from this amazing Quran. And every single morning, subhanallah, we are benefiting and learning something new. And we are, subhanallah, it gives us comfort, mashallah. It consoles us, subhanallah. Every morning, sometimes when you feel like giving up, okay, the Quran gives you that energy. It wakes you up. The Quran gives you hope. You can see our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam being told, you have been given a very, very hard mission. Okay? Calling people to Islam. And the mushrikun are like this. They hate your tawheed. And the people of the book, they have doubts. They're not going to follow you. Okay? They will struggle to follow you. And then still the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is being told, continue with the da'wah. Don't give up. So us right now as Muslims, we must never ever think like this and say, what's the point of giving da'wah? No one is going to listen to me. Look at the media, is very powerful. Whatever I say, it won't make sense to the people. No, don't say that. فَلِذَٰلِكَ فَدْعُوا وَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتَ وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ. You have to do your bit. Don't worry about others and how they will react to it. You need to do your part. فَلِذَٰلِكَ فَدْعُوا وَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتَ. The Prophet is being told, call the people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you be upright upon this path. وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ. And do not follow their desires, subhanAllah. So as Muslims right now, yes, things are difficult. We are living in the end of times. The situation is not easy. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and also reminding us by extension, yes, the situation is not going to be easy, but still you have to stand up and establish the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Call the people to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't worry about people not listening to you. Don't worry about people not following the religion of Islam. You have to do your part. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us those who do their part in this religion. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us those who die upon Islam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us those who invest in the next life. Not, من كان يريد حرث الآخرة نزيد له في حرثه. Look, every investment. And inshallah ta'ala, the ayat that are to come tomorrow morning and the morning after, unbelievable stuff. Unbelievable stuff will be coming, subhanAllah, in this surah. Some of the things, inshaAllah ta'ala, the characteristics of the believer, the ayat that will be coming, and subhanAllah, how Allah talks about this dunya, we will see it, inshaAllah ta'ala. And now, alhamdulillah, this morning, the lesson we should take from this passage was, okay, regardless of how hard things are, don't worry about it. Continue with the da'wah of Allah. Okay? Stand up for Islam. Okay? Don't give in. Don't say, everybody's against me. Don't say things are challenging, times are challenging. No, you keep going. Continue with the religion of Islam. Give da'wah as much as you can. Okay? Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.